it happen. I got a job as a software engineer.
Let's go.
If you don't know me, my name's Ilolo. Welcome to the channel. For the past couple months, I have been looking for new engineering jobs that I was laid off in about October of last year. Currently, right now, I've been working for my new position as a software engineer one for about a month now, and it's been going really, really well. In this video, I'm going to tell you guys a little bit about the journey and about what I learned about myself over the past few months of applying to all these jobs. Before we get started, quickly, I know it's been a while. I haven't been making videos, obviously, because I've been applying to jobs. That's kind of been my pure focus. Been a little bit overwhelmed with that, and in addition to that, I just wanted to make sure that I was my best self when I came back to the camera. I have been recording videos, have two or three that I've made. I just wanted to post this one first, so that was a priority, but I'm glad to be back. I'm glad to see y'all back and expect more from the channel, expect more content. So let's get this thing started.
Y'all been telling jokes that's gonna stress me out. Soon as I walk in, I'm like, let's be out. I was off the chain, I was often drained, I was off the meds, I was called the same. What an awesome thing, get off the shame. I want all the rain, I want all the pain, I want all the smoke, I want all the blame. Cardio, audio, let me jog the brain. Calling the arty home, we was all detained. All of you Mario, it's all a game.
I'm so reborn. I'm moving forward. Keep moving forward. Keep moving forward. Ain't no stress on me, Lord. I'm moving forward. Keep moving forward. Keep moving forward.
So Winston Churchill once said that success is not final, failure is not fatal, and it is the courage to continue that counts. And I really think that this is super applicable to getting laid off or losing a job. Losing a job can be an incredibly challenging outlook, and it can be even more challenging to stay positive and continue on the same track when you're moving forward, when you're searching for that next position. However, Churchill's quote tells us that success isn't a one-time thing, and neither is failure. Instead of that, success and failure are a little bit sort of an ongoing journey. Getting laid off doesn't mean that, you know, one's career is over or that they've necessarily failed. Rather, it's more of an opportunity to seek back on past experiences, take in everything that you know, and learn from new mistakes and to make the best of it, to make new opportunities. I think that this quote really just kind of tells us that success and failure are never absolute. Things can change at a moment's notice, and it's important to stay on our toes, stay prepared, create an overarching goal for your life, something that without a shadow of a doubt, you're going to accomplish. And I think that by having that goal in mind, you'll be prepared for whatever opportunity comes your way. Over these past few months, I definitely was struggling, trying to do whatever it took to get this next opportunity, to get this next job. Mentally, I think it took a really big toll on me. I think one of the positive things, one of the best things that I did for myself was just creating a really good schedule, something that I could stick by, something that I knew I would 100% do every single day, no matter what, just to ensure that I was getting 1% closer towards getting that job. Over the last 2 months, I applied to about 400 to 500 jobs, got about 30 interviews, made it to about 5 to 6 final stages, ended up getting 2 offers. In the first 2 weeks of searching for a job, I was able to get an offer. You have to go into AproTech. I don't know if I told you guys that. And then also at about month 3 is where I got my second offer. So ultimately, I would say that the process went pretty well for me. So from what y'all can tell, man, I mean, at the end of the day, it was definitely tough. It was definitely tough. But I think that kind of just staying on track and staying focused and understanding that, you know, it's going to get done, it's going to happen, was the key motivator in pushing me through all of this. I think that there's so many things that, you know, maybe I could dive into in another video or dive into in the comments. But I genuinely believe that if you just stick the course and if you just stay confident in the things that you're trying to get done, stay confident in the person that you know you want to be, it's going to happen. You just have to continue showing up. Just keep trying your best to get there. And I know that I've said this in other videos, but I genuinely think it holds so much truth, is that the more you show up, the more likely it is for whatever you want to happen. So yeah, so I'm super excited to get back into the swing of things, to get back to coding. My new job is gonna be a software engineer one. So no longer a junior, which is pretty lit. I'm gonna be working still as a full stack software engineer in TypeScript, React, GraphQL. So a little bit new to GraphQL, but I think it'll be a learning curve that I can definitely conquer. So if you guys wanna see any day-to-day life of a software engineer, day-to-day coding, just hit me up, let me know, and I'll be sure to do that for y'all. And with that being said, please make sure you guys like, comment, subscribe. It helps the channel out. And I'll see y'all next time. Peace.
Ain't no stress on me, Lord. I'm moving forward.